Hi everyone, my name is Krishna and I hope you all are doing great. In my previous videos, I mentioned how we can install custom OS on our Pixel 4a device and recover it from recent Google update and from the battery issue. But then a few of you had some major concern. Like some of you said that what if we want to sell our phone? What if we want to exchange it on Flipkart? Will Flipkart accept my phone with the custom OS? Well, in this video, I'm going to tell you guys how you can go back to stock Android. That means how you can make your phone as it is at it. How you can make your phone as it is as it was before after installing custom OS. So in this video, I'm going to tell you how you can install stock Android on your Pixel 4a device and make your device as it was before. If you don't want the custom OS and you are good to go with the stock Android, you are okay with the battery issue, you will replace your battery and you want to go back to stock Android, this video will be helpful for you. In this video, we will see how we can go back to stock Android or remove custom OS from your Pixel 4a device and install stock Android. So first step is we need to turn on the developer option on our phone. So to do that, you need to go to your settings and go to about phone. I'm using Project Elixir on my phone as a custom OS. So I'm here and I'm clicking on build number 7 times. So it will turn on this developer option. Okay, so the developer option is turned on now. And from here, once the developer option is turned on, go to system. And from system, go to developer option. And from here, make sure that you are turning on the OEM unlocking and turn on the USB debugging. Okay, click OK. Now our USB debugging is turned on and our OEM unlocking is turned on. Great. So our next step is make sure your phone is connected to a USB cable, and this USB cable you need to connect to your laptop. Okay, so now our next step is done. Once your USB cable is connected to the laptop and USB debugging is on, you will see a screen like this. On this screen, you need to select allow. Now you need to visit this link. The link is in the description. Okay, and click. So once you click on the link, interface will open like this. So click on allow ADB access. Once you click on allow ADB access, it will show your device over here. It might show it is already in use. If you see this kind of error, just select and go to terminal on your phone and write down the command ADB kill dash server. Okay, and then again click on add device. You will see your device over here. Click on connect and then you will see a pop-up on your screen like this. Allow this computer and click allow. Once it is done, you will see your device over there. You will see the build. Click on install build. Then click on confirm. Then click on I accept. Once you do that, your phone will automatically start rebooting. And then on your screen, you can see that it is downloading the latest update, like the latest software update for your phone. I want to tell you guys, this is the latest firmware that was updated by Google. So after installing this latest firmware, you will still face the battery issues. So if you think that after reinstalling this firmware, you might be able to get rid of the battery issue, no, it will not resolve your battery issue. But in case if you want a stock Android and after that you want to replace your battery, this is a method that you can use. Or you want to exchange your phone, in that situation, if you want to resell it, exchange it, you can go back to the stock Android. This method works for all your Pixel devices, not just Pixel 4a. So if you want to install stock Android on any other Pixel devices, you can use this process. Our file is downloaded now and it will reboot our device. It will flash it. As you see, your device might reboot so many times. Don't worry or don't get scared. Nothing will happen to your device. It will just format the data. Make sure that they are installing the custom OS and the software on your device. So now our stock Android is installed and it is asking you to lock our device. So you will see a prompt like this, click on start. Once you click on start on your phone, you will see a screen like this. And by using the volume button, you can slide it down and click on lock the bootloader. Once you select that, your phone will lock the bootloader and click on done. Once you click on done, your phone will reboot and you will see your device is locked and your installation is successful. You will see your phone is rebooting now in stock Android, like how your original phone was. See, it has a stock Android now.